European, do you feel European?
So first of all, I never actually understood what it means to be European, and I never understood what do people keep discussing about, what is this discussion about, until I actually started traveling and actually meeting people around Europe, and then I understood that there are a lot of things that unite us in a certain way that initially appears as differences. So due to the historical perspective of all the cultural clashes throughout thousands of years in Europe, this is something that we, I think, all have in common. A history of cultural clashes and being used to different cultures and being used to different languages. This is also something that most European countries have, that a lot of people speak at least two languages, not necessarily due to the geographical perspective, but also to the openness of understanding different cultures. And this is, I think, one important aspect of what makes Europe what it is.
Or like, how would you explain to someone what the difference would be between a European and an American?
Well, first of all, the geographical perspective is completely different, because whereas in the US you can go thousands of kilometers, or miles in this case, and you have the same culture, the same language, the same traditions, and whereas in Europe you can sometimes just walk 50 kilometers and it's a completely different region with different cultures.
You live nowadays in the outskirts of Europe, one might say. Taking Ukraine as an example, where would you say the borders of Europe go?
The borders of Europe are, in my perspective, more in the minds of people than a line on the map. Actually, since I live in Ukraine, my perspective of Europe changed quite a lot. I always took it for granted, like most of us. But now I live in a country where people dream of going to Europe, and I always say them that they are in Europe. But it's really part of a mindset, and we don't always realize how great it is to live in a united Europe, and how much of a dream it is for people who don't have these same benefits yet and have to fight for it.
We are saying how one nation is very different from other. We are talking about stereotypes quite a lot. Do we focus, in your opinion, too much on those stereotypes and less on kind of maybe the common values and the similarities we have in Europe?
I mean, for sure that in Europe we feel, we sometimes make fun of each other, and there are stereotypes for each country. Some of us are more strict, some of us are looser, some of us are, it's just different, but it, in the end, it makes us, I think it unites us more. And as Sorana was saying, we are used to that. I mean, I grew up with different languages and different cultures, and for me it's just normal. It would be weird if I would just be with Portuguese people all the time.
Do you think that everyone in your country shares that thought, shares the concept that it would be weird to only belong to that nation?
I mean, I would just yeah, quickly comment about Portugal. Well, I don't consider my country as being, or my nation as being racist or anything. I don't think they are. Of course, there's always more conservative people than others. There will always be, even on the freest nation of all times.
I think the people that are not accepting towards new cultures and are a little bit more traditional in the sense, or maybe even nationalistic, these people probably haven't been exposed to the right environments or to the right people who would actually shape them and give them the right mindset, I would say. That's why from this perspective I'm very open towards programs like Erasmus, who actually get people out of their comfort zone and get exploring a new culture, or international student organizations that make people travel around and discover new cultures, and then they actually get a sense and get a taste of what it actually means to be European.
Do you think that it is conceivable that Europe, or people in Europe, also at some point in time in future will see themselves more as Europeans, as opposed to belonging to being Portuguese, being Romanian?
I think there is a possibility that this will happen, and I very much hope so. that will happen. But then again, I'm sure there will be more challenges in the future. It's just a matter of how we currently prepare for these challenges. I think we definitely have to work for it, and we have to work together to actually increase this feeling of being a little bit more united and having this European feeling. It's something to work for sure, and a lot of effort has to be put into it.
I don't necessarily agree. I think I love being European, but I will always be Portuguese. I like the history of my country. It's a very old history, and I think that we should all strive to keep the history of our countries alive, because in the end that's what brought Europe together, and so we should be one, but still with our own personality in terms of country and our own history. So I think we should strive to keep that. So in a sense, don't get me wrong, but I'll always be Portuguese and then European.
I think the strength of Europe is in its diversity. Europe has not the same strong historical background as you feel with your country or with your region. I mean, also within countries nowadays, people in many cases feel like part of their region more than their country, and that's also no problem within those countries. I see a future with a more united Europe for practical reasons, but not to create one culture or something.
So we're having the first switch of seats for the night, so please introduce yourself.
I'm Federico from Brussels, from Belgium, and I just wanted to add that I strongly believe that it is a possibility that future generations will identify more as European as than their own country, because current developments like in the United States or even in Europe with the surge of right-wing parties have one, I think, major benefit, which is that people talk more about Europe and about the values and about why we strive for a united Europe. And that, I believe, helps, especially for millennials, for example, to talk about it. And more in Belgium, for example, people feel as European before they say that they are Belgian. So I think that it's an absolute possible evolution.
Is that possible, or is that like basically by becoming European you kind of give up a bit of your national identity?
I think that Americans in that aspect lead by example, because they combine very well that they are, for example, American but New Yorkers, and they combine very well their patriotism and their love for their country, but the love for the region they are coming from. And I believe with the strong history that each country has in Europe, that it is absolutely possible to keep one's love for their own country, but see the value and see the benefit of being united with neighboring countries.
I'm Sunny David from Germany. When it comes to boundaries, personally, the boundaries are basically money. I'm a student, can't afford to travel too far away. But if you see the infrastructure in Europe, it's super cheap to go everywhere around, by bus, by plane. And the only reason why, I not explore so far America or Asia is because I can't afford it so far. But I have the chance to travel to Europe, and I've been in the past like all over the place, like from Helsinki to also Istanbul as the southern part, and Portugal as well, and also the Eastern Europe part. And I really believe that we have a lot of good opportunities, but right now also to change their minds a little bit, like go in the small villages and spread up the word.